Hi, my name is Jonathan Menendez, and I am originally from Venice, California. I am a multimedia producer, master's in digital arts and new media. My projects currently consist of co-founding Qulture.org, the Latino Queer Arts and Film Festival, and the documentary Gay Latino LA. Coming out as a queer Latino happened through the internet, really excavating my identity by way of digital interfaces and going on AOL and chatting with other guys. I didn't realize that there was a whole world out there of other guys that were like me that are either bi or you know, so I went online, I saw male for male chat rooms, and I decided, hey, let's start talking to guys and saying that I'm bi. And also there was this thing called the party line. It was a number that you'd call up and then you'd talk to people at random. And I would always pretend to do a girl voice. I'd be like, hey, what's up? And they'd be like, oh, you sound cute, mama. And then I'd talk to them and pretend to be a girl. And I was like, wait, what am I doing? Is this really happening? Like, what's going on? So that's when I realized, yo, like, I'm definitely different, you know? So a combination of the party lines and chat rooms online really created my queer identity by meeting guys and then later defining myself in college as gay and now currently queer. The work that I do now is definitely always been about healing and finding ways that I can create healing for myself and healing for our comunidad, healing for our spirits, you know, of a history of colonialization that has really taken away our ability to be strong and to be powerful and to have these voices heard. So I feel that the work that I'm doing is carrying on the legacy of many people that have come before me that have shaped visibility and have shaped openness and empowerment. So the work that I do as queer has heavily influenced all the work that I do. It's con esa pasión that I move forward and with these projects to really create visibility, representation, empowerment for individuals who don't always have voices. Social media is revolutionizing the way that we all identify, the way that we connect, the way that we understand ourselves, and it's shifting cultural norms. It's allowing us to represent ourselves in ways where we are now have video channels that are queer. We now have networks that are queer. You know, we have people of color networks, we have queer people of color networks, and so on. So what this means to me as a digital producer is that we have this whole beautiful universe of the internet that we can really utilize to share our information, to share our stories, to be a vehicle of transformation and visibility. So I'm currently a teaching assistant at the University of California, Santa Cruz, and working with youth allows for them to really identify somebody that is, you know, pretty young like them, or I have this young personality. So they're seeing this Latino queer person that is doing things, that's, you know, shaking and stirring things up. They're inspired and they're really, you know, they seek me as somebody to work with and they believe me. You know, there's this authenticity that comes from, you know, me saying I'm going crazy with these projects, I'm going through it, this is stressful, you know, it's not easy work, and so I tell them that. I'm very honest, I'm very transparent. I'm being transparent right now saying that the stuff that I'm doing is stressful because of my personality type, because I'm very scattered, but I also have a very specific focus, which is to work with the community, to create bridges, to create networks of social change, and to inspire others. So the students really, listen to that authenticity, I think, and are inspired by it. When I was in Mexico City in 2012, I was there for the premiere of my documentary, Gay Latino Los Angeles. It was the world premiere. And someone told me about the 41, and I don't need to repeat the story because y'all should know what it is, but I was inspired by that, and I ended up getting a tattoo, which I have right here, and for me this represents a victory in the area of gay Latinidad, you know, the cultura. For me to be at a world premiere of my film in across, you know, in a different country. I mean, for me, that's like, okay, I've accomplished one big thing in my life that is propelling my identity as queer Latinos, and so I had to get that tattooed. And so since then, I'm like, every time I go to a different country, I'm gonna get a new tattoo. So 41 was like one, is something that's really personal to me, because it's all about, you know, a push forward and to come out and to be yourself. So yeah.
Hola.